Welcome to another edition of Pittsburgh Sports Line at Sips Sports Bar, 3024 Downtown Dormont, that's West Liberty Avenue, 15216, 3024 for Sips. We have a great day in sports. We got a great crowd here. You can hear from all the chatter and noise. They're all excited about everything. We got a great lineup like every week, but we do have a few extra guests. We may have to limit their time. I have an egg timer, including Big Mike D's back after a one-month-long hiatus. He come back from, I don't know where it is, the Draculich's hangout somewhere, maybe Romania, but he'll be here. We'll see him up here shortly. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine. We got Smokin' Jim Frazier, Chip the Prophet Hainer, and we're going to go right to what's on our mind. What's on your mind?
What's on my mind? Thanks, Alan. Good evening, everybody. It has been an interesting sports week. I believe there was a new NBA champion crowned, but there's no luck for them from
me here. Jim, we picked that.
Yeah, we did. You know, I like to, if anybody's followed our show over the years, I've always liked to take the commissioners of all the major sports organizations to task. You know, you've got David Stern, the clown that runs the NBA. He doesn't seem to have any idea what he's doing. And Gary Bettman's a joke on his best day. And who is Bud Selig? Has anybody seen him?
Who?
But what I really want to take to task is the commissioner of the NFL, Roger Goodell. You know, apparently there's some goings on with one of the members of the favorite sons of the NFL, the New England Patriots, who's under suspicion for, you know, an involvement in a murder, who's got pending charges of obstruction of justice going on against him. And my question is where is the commissioner and why hasn't he fined him? Why hasn't he suspended him? I mean, look what he did to the quarterback of the Steelers. Ben Roethlisberger was accused of some crimes, and no charges were ever brought, but he got a six-game suspension. And, you know, here we go, the New England Patriots again. They get busted for cheating. The commissioner makes the evidence go away. What's he do? He slaps him on the wrist. Now, you know, another one of their star players is in the news, could be involved in a murder or the cover-up of one. And what's Roger Goodell doing? Nothing. You know, it's about time that he stays consistent and, you know, adjudicates these people equally the same way he does us. But that's what's on my mind, Alan.
Hey. Chip, that was great. Can't say I disagree with you one bit on anything you said. Sometimes we do disagree on this show. We're not always yes men here. All three of us are far from a yes man. Or yes man. So, hey, Smokin' Jim, what's on your mind?
Hey, thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. And if you want the green, you got to see Levine.
Got that pen. Thanks, buddy.
And I tell you what, we're very lucky to have some outstanding guests tonight. I just wanted to acknowledge one beautiful young lady that drove in from Ohio. She's going to be a guest later on in the show. Outstanding young lady, graduated from Point Park College in dance, can do all different forms of dance, from ballet, you just name it. I nicknamed her Lips, Hips, and Fingertips. She's so beautiful. She is my co-host, my sports anchor on Social Curve TV. So please give a warm round of applause to Alicia Sparks. Wave to all your fans, Alicia. And everybody that knows me knows I love women. So you can understand how mad I was when I watched Chad Johnson walk in the court with a head looking like a giant milk dud. He was in court because he used that head to headbutt his wife. Listen, you can get away with beating up women in Cincinnati because the toughest guy in Cincinnati is only 5'2", 125-pound Cat Williams. But I guarantee you, if Chad Johnson were to beat up a female family member of mine, me and my brothers would have knocked on his back door and I guarantee you he wouldn't have been able to river dance his way out of the beatdown I'd have gave him. Listen, this is the same clown that during the Monday Night Football game, when he scored a touchdown, he put on a Hall of Fame blazer, but this fool shows up to court in a t-shirt, laughing and joking and patting his attorney on the butt. Hey, listen, this is the same only a few months after Kansas City Chiefs linebacker Javon Belcher murdered his girlfriend and committed suicide. I take domestic violence on women very seriously because a woman is the most beautiful thing on earth. The reason America is number one, the reason Americans are the number one most productive, smartest people on earth is because of women. Listen, a mother is the teacher, the first teacher to a child. That's why in the days of Moses, if you beat up a woman, you got stoned to death. And just like Moses parted the Red Sea, we need to split a 6'3", 190-pound milk dud.
Smoking Jim, I don't know how you do it. That was so impressive. First, the volume. I'll be ready to hear in a couple minutes, so I'll just talk a little bit. You went biblical on us. That was fantastic. I didn't know how you could go to Moses on that from a mother and everything else. I thought you were going to bring out the reed basket that he was in. Well, I just want to thank Smoking Jim Frazier. He gave me an opportunity on a reality show, and people know we're not allowed to talk about it because we signed double releases, so I can only talk about what's public. And it was a great night. Aaron Ward was in the house. We had our young photographer with us, Jake. I kept him out way past his bedtime. Didn't get in trouble with his parents because I dropped him off at his house. So we did have some fun there. We were in a great boxing club. And I don't mean to create any competition because there's an Irish boxer in the house that Kian has such a strong-looking jaw. I know he can take a punch, and I'm sure he can give one. But we met Jeff Mucci, who runs the Wolfpack Boxing Club. We're going to try to get out there and visit his place. It's actually in Scott Township, not Carnegie. And it was a great venue for a fight. I ended up losing, I think, about 10 pounds, so it was not air conditioned the first night, but it was a great thing. It'll be coming out later this year.
Did you put on some weight?
Can I have some fries? These guys, oh, my finger. That's my finger, Chip. Jeez. Now we have this national uni tournament up in Seneca Valley in Butler. Dave Crack, I talked to Dr. Trina Hess. She's up to 29 minutes on a unicycle riding, so she might be competitive. Dev and I are going to probably take a road trip and try to do some filming up there. That's the week of July 21st to the 27th. And I found out why Dave Crack can't come back to the show. They have, no, he's not on drugs. We already got that straightened out. He was sitting next to somebody in school that their name was cocaine. He told us that story. Check the videos. But he actually teaches unicycling on Monday nights, and it's free. And they get up to maybe 50 people there learning to ride the unicycle. So if you have a unicycle, they'll even let you come up there or they'll share one with you. Hey, what's on my mind is the Pirates. I drank that Kool-Aid, Chip, I forget how many weeks ago. It was sour. If you gave me the same Kool-Aid, it would be sweet. And I'm even on MVP, Pedro. El Toro. A little seasoning, his second year of baseball, full season. He's coming through. I don't care as long as he's above the Mendoza line. For all of you that don't know Mendoza, it's over 200. So we're going to move forward now with this show. I'm going to cut short. I got a couple other opinions, but we'll keep that short, and we're going to get into our guests next. He's Pittsburgh Sports Nation, folks. He's everywhere. You can check him, tweet, whatever. He does all that, Facebook. He's got a couple pages. But you got to check our page out, Pittsburgh Sports Line on Facebook.
Like it.
I think Some of my fans are getting a little dry here. They have a drinking contest. I don't know if I mentioned Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. We're up to 287. Devin, are we up to 288 on there yet? Okay. No, we're not there yet. All right, Big Mike D. You got so much sports going on, buddy.
Yes.
And you were gone for so long. The Penguins lost, if you didn't notice.
Yeah,
so,
I was going to call you and say Penguins at 5.
I'm glad you didn't. I'm glad we had no calls like that. All right, what do you want to? What's on your mind here?
What an ugly series that was. I mean, they hit a lot of posts. They were unlucky. Boston took it to them. What can you say? All you do is hope you find the right pieces. You go back next year and try again. I mean,
right.
The main core, obviously, is 24, 25, 26 years old. So
right.
There's a rather large picture window to do this. But
do you have any thoughts on who they're keeping?
I would like to see them, you know, obviously, re-sign Letang.
Right.
But it has to be the right guy. Price. He can't be going for $7 or $8 million, $9 million a year. Well, if they could get him at like a Carlson type deal at $6.5 million a year, you know, I'll do that.
There's a couple of defensemen that have already signed have raised the bar on what we could get away with paying Letang. And I mean, I can't blame the kid for wanting to go for as much as he can get, you know. So it'll be we'll see if we can fit him under the cap, because the cap space is going down this year.
It's going down this year.
By $7 or $8 million, so it'll make it a little more.
But they also did say, you know how greedy sets in. They said that it's more likely to go right back up the year after. So
what they need to do is extend him and pay him next year at the current salary. Let the new contract take effect once his cap goes
back. If you want to keep him for a long time and give him a good bank account, I mean, obviously you do like 6-5 for 10 years if you want to do that. Something
right.
They can work with it. But Ray Shero has been proven that if someone's going to play around in negotiations, he will trade you.
Didn't he just make a trade today? He traded a defenseman that we had drafted that didn't get to the NHL yet, and he picked up a forward. I just saw something come across.
I didn't get the full name. I was kind of whacking
it. Well, you do have a job where you're tied up sometimes.
Yeah,
that's one of the reasons. You weren't the jitney driver like you were the one show you missed. Because we did catch you driving people out to the airport. You know that. You're on video.
Unfortunately.
The security picked you up.
And how did I get repaid by that?
I have no idea.
I got separated. You know,
hold it. We try to keep domestic stuff out of here. Smoking Jim's our man, no violence.
Well, I figured I'd come on. There's like lovely ladies out there. So I'm taking applications. Taking applications
hold
for the
we'll,
new.
We'll have our BPTV dating show. We'll run that during the day. Let's talk sports.
Let's do this. Let's go. A
couple more minutes for you, buddy, because you look at these guests. They're starting to move forward on us. Whoa.
It's a full house. I mean,
it
got
is.
Waitresses. We got
come
all
to Sip Sports Bar, 3024 West Liberty Avenue. We got Kamikaze Kid here. Whoa, Antina's here.
Woo!
We started without her, because I never say Antina anymore, but Chuck paid me $5. So I had to. All right, Mike, go ahead.
I figure next time we'll go in a little detail how the one we got was gone with the Serb National Federation basketball.
Well, hold it. Tell us right now, because I've been promoting you, and a couple guys didn't want to believe that.
Well, see, there's a tournament every year.
Okay.
The Serb National Federation hosts a basketball tournament.
All right.
And it's
and you're
going
a player
on
that team.
We've gone on for 74 years. So this year was the 74th tournament. And unfortunately,
and this is the first I'm here in the morning.
Well, it doesn't go out though. What do you say, Hazelwood?
Up for saying Hazelwood.
Yeah, there's like certain restrictions.
Up for saying Hazelwood.
Unfortunately, my own friends.
Okay, now where do you play these games? Give us some of that.
Well, normally it's somewhere out in the Midwest, so everyone can connect and get around there. I mean, like, I guess back in our. Back in the day, they'd have tournaments around here in Pittsburgh.
Man. I'm not as old as you.
Well, I didn't go there. I was going close to going there. I was going to say, when you were a young lad, maybe they were around this
area. I'm a little bit older than you. Your hair is keeping its color. Mine's not. So.
Getting a little gray after the
I'll give events. You a few dozen. No, where do they play?
Normally, every other year, it normally goes up to Schererville or Maryville, Indiana, which is located south of Chicago. And sometimes you have South Chicago or North Chicago, Milwaukee sometimes. Canton was a couple years ago, and it's going back there again next year. This year was in Detroit.
There you go, Smoking Jim.
Detroit.
Hall of Fame.
Detroit, Van Dyke, and 8
Murder
Mile.
Murder City.
That's where we were. No one tried to kill me while I was walking to my hotel, so I was kind of pleased about that result.
Good.
Yeah, so.
So what happened? Give us the game, because then we're going to have to boot you off the show next week.
Now, see, normally we have a bunch of good, a couple teams from Pittsburgh. We had Duquesne Serbs and we had Pittsburgh Serbs.
What are you?
Most of which I played with, but apparently I wasn't good enough to play on their team, even though I won a championship last year.
Okay.
None of them guys have a ring, so they're like like pre-LeBron. They have no ring.
Okay.
See, I have a ring. See, I have to
bring
play
that Serbian ring next week.
I'm bringing the medal, the gold medal.
Bring the medal, all right.
I happen to play for a team from Chicago. I have a bunch of, I had a couple of friends out there last year. They like, Drek, do you want to play for us? I was like, yeah, none of my guys want me to play, so I'll go out and play for you guys. So we ended up winning the championship.
And that's how you got it.
So this year, once again, they're like, hey, you're part of the team now, let's go. So we showed up, and we had six guys to start. And we had three guys from last year that were missing.
Right.
So we only had six guys. We're missing three key ingredients from the year before. And not to mention our star point guard got into a wreck the night before. He actually had a concussion going to Detroit.
I can't figure out how you won.
Well, we had three kids that are like 18, 19, 20, and a couple of them are going to Division II. And the two guys, it was lights out. They get the ball, it is like, you know, Ray Allen, three-pointer, good night, and that's it.
Nice.
So we made it to the championship game against all odds.
Right.
The first game was one of the toughest tests. We were down by 6 points with about 4 minutes left. Called a timeout. One of their guys on, I think it was an Indiana team we were playing, started running his mouth walking towards our bench when we called a timeout. And, well, you hold the term, you don't poke the bear. Well, they poked the bear because we were on a 15-2 run to end the game.
Nice.
So we're about 20 seconds left and we were shooting technicals. I looked at that same dude and said, hey, better use your timeout. And the same thing he mouthed to our bench, so I wasn't too happy about that.
Nice. But, so you won the game, you get a championship.
Well, we go to the championship game, we're playing against Duquesne Serbs. And, no, I let our main five guys play the whole game.
Right.
We have 1.2 seconds left in this game. We're up by 3 points.
Right.
They throw a four-coin length pass. He tips to the guy at the top of the key, and he just throws up a shot, and it goes in the net. So we're going to overtime. A minute into overtime, one of our guys fouls out. So in comes Drek.
Okay.
And they're all talking smack from the bench because the previous day we're in the parking lot having a couple of beers thinking, you know, Drek, you going to do something to us? I'm like, we'll find out if I get in. So I get in there and I played some defense, doing well.
You're building the suspense perfectly, but we got to roll.
We have about 5 seconds left.
Okay.
I get fouled. They were trying to foul me to get me to the line, which is the dumbest thing they could do because I practice free throws a lot. I know when we play our game. So that's one thing I am really good at. 5 seconds left. We're up by three. And they're talking all this smack a little bit. I can hear him catcalling from the bench. All I can see is the net, no crowd, walk up to the line, and hit nothing but net. And then I turn towards their bench. And, of course, they're from Pittsburgh. And I flash the Z towards them. Because they're being Pittsburgh people. You know, and me also being from Midland had a little bit of cockiness in me and say, tried to foul me, you got your wish, game's over, go up by four. And I also made the second one, you know, put us up by five. And as I was walking to middle court with my hand in the air and also flashing that Z again towards their bench saying, you wanted to foul me, you got your wish, good night, see y'all next year. Maybe next year you get another chance at the title. But this year,
and on that,
the Drac got two. So
the Drac got two. He brought the championship back to Pittsburgh by way of Chicago. He was on a mission from God with the Blues Brothers.
And what is it about Pittsburgh people going to Detroit to win championships, whether it's the Penguins, the Steelers, or me?
Let's schedule that every year. We'll talk about it online.
Hey, maybe the Pirates will do it this year. They'll beat the Tigers.
Let's go up there and whip them, too. I told them we play your team and we get the same treatment. Whoop time.
Frank, thanks, Big Mike D.
My boys, I miss you. I can't wait to see you all next week.
We miss you, too.
My name is Alicia Sparks. As previously stated, I do hail from Ohio. Yay! I am a Pittsburgh Steelers fan. I'm a Pittsburgh Steelers fan.
You're not from Cleveland, are you?
I'm not from Cleveland. I'm exactly...
Because I feel sorry for the ones from Cleveland now.
I don't.
Well, I do. The river's on fire.
It is.
Nobody lives in the city. They're all outside. Where are you from since I interrupted?
I'm actually closer to Youngstown, so I'm about an hour away from Cleveland.
An hour or so from us.
Exactly. I'm right halfway in between both places.
And you're a Steeler fan. Well, that's all good. You got the gold.
I am.
And you got black on, too.
Yeah, I was smart. I was thinking.
Oh, any graduate from Point Park College. Gotta be smart.
You don't have a choice. You don't right. have a, and you don't have a choice but to be a Steelers fan growing up and being in the city. You know, while you're in college, when everything shuts down, you don't have a choice. I mean,
you can shop if you want.
Yeah, no.
It looks like you might shop a little bit.
Just a little bit, not a lot.
Oh, really?
Just a little bit.
Hey, what's this show that you're a co-host with Smoke and Jim?
Social
I wanted to
Curve.
Hear.
Social Curve. You know, you look at me and you would think I would be on the fashion aspect of things, but I'm co-hosting with Smokin'. And, you know, we talk about sports and we talk about a little bit of this and a little bit of that, and I kind of bring the spark.
Okay, well, Sparks.
Yes.
One thing that he likes is one of his favorite parts is a shoe.
Uh-huh.
That's what he says.
Woo!
I mean,
this was a family show. The disclaimer on this.
It still is. Just with good shoes. That's all.
Yeah, we're fans of big shoes, and he's not only an NFL scout. I'm promoting as one of the best scouts of models.
I love it.
So that's his new. Well, not his new field. He always does.
Scouts
that.
Of models, though.
Well, then women models.
It sounds like we might need to connect because I'm starting my own modeling agency.
Well, there you go.
And you already got the curse.
Oh, we might change the name of that show. Who's producing that show? I'll produce your show on BP TV.
On BP, let's go.
Yeah, because we're seen on Verizon 32 in the area.
Okay.
Comcast 7 in Bethel.
Mm-hmm.
And some people want me to say Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook, but it's also YouTube.
Oh.
And this show will probably be broadcast Tuesday night. Dave Cable does it. We got Aaron Ward here. Devin Shea just come out on a mission. I'm really not allowed to talk about that or white collar boxing. He's in uniform. He did take his name tag off
took
a minute,
off.
So I thought
yes.
he was on Black Ops.
Yes.
But it's back on.
Back on.
So we do have a little bit of fun. Who else is your favorite team or what other sports do you follow, or is it just the Steelers?
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. I like to follow all different sports. Of course, I did watch the Heat win. You know, with LeBron being from not too far away from where I'm from, you know, I kind of feel bad for the city of Cleveland, but at the same time, I think he's representing what a product of Ohio and what a product of the area can go on and pursue and do. So, you know, for those people who are holding their head low for LeBron, I say put your chin up because he's representing what we do in the Midwest. So
that's a great spin on that.
Yes.
You turned it into something positive.
It is something positive.
Did your high school friend Maurice Claret get out of jail yet?
He might be. I don't know. Yes, I did go to high school.
You can't spin that into something positive.
No.
Except he's reformed, baby.
I don't want to. Okay. I don't want to.
That shows your good sense.
Yeah, I don't want to. I won't pick up for him. No.
What other sports are you interested in?
You know, I do like football. I mean, I love football. I come from a football family.
Oh, do you?
I have tons of people in my family who have either played for the NFL or do play for the NFL.
Well, tease us with a couple names because then maybe they can come visit us.
Well, we've got a. I'll name drop. We've got a, Daniel Boomheron, who plays for the Cincinnati Bengals. He's my little cousin. Little big cousin.
The running back.
Yes, the running
from
back.
Ohio State.
Yeah. Smoking Jim's learning something, or that's just part of his little routine.
Right, no, I don't know.
I can't figure it out.
You know, that's a good thing. That's what they want to see. Also, TV. Prescott Burgess, the Baltimore Ravens linebacker. David Heron of, yeah, no, Ravens. Oops, sorry. Can't say that here.
That's all right. We have the Gradkowski family.
Okay.
One's on the Steelers. And the youngest son, Gino, I'll show you the picture. They texted me the ring, Super Bowl ring with Gradkowski on it. There's rumors we might get him up here.
Okay.
And now he's a big guy, too, about 300 pounds.
Yeah, yeah. But, you know, lots and lots and lots of people in my family. I also was, too, very close in the Steelers family. My ex-fiancé played for the Steelers, Gary
you
Russell.
Said ex.
Ex.
He was great running back. Great
smoking Jim, there's still hope for you. I know you stopped dating 5 years ago. I'm starting a matchmaking thing. But as we start to wind down. What project are you most excited about doing right now? Because I know you've got a lot on your plate.
I have so much on my plate.
Pick one, then. And then we'll have you back another time, only if you want to come back.
Oh, I will be back. I'll be back every time I can get back. My number one project that I'm working on right now is bringing in several celebrity photographers into the area to develop my brand and to develop my modeling agency.
Oh, okay.
I have a photo shoot that's coming up this weekend. It's going to be huge. Going to be producing some models.
Where's it
going to
be?
It will be in Ohio.
Okay. Well, you can promote it.
Ohio.
Pittsburgh people travel.
Yes,
if you give them opportunities.
Yes,
of course, they live in a lot of cities.
Yes.
But if you want to tell people where they can get a hold of you.
Well, you can find me on Facebook at Alicia Sparks. You can find me on Instagram at Role Model Life. You can find me on Twitter at Miss Dallionaire. I'm pretty much all over the place everywhere. So
I found her on Facebook.
You did.
And on that, we're going to have to go.
Well, wait one second. I want to extend an offer. This is not rehearsed.
I am looking for
a boxing co-host. Would you be interested?
I most definitely.
There we go. I'm going to spend a lot of intense days and nights in Ohio.
Training.
Get ready.
Let's go.
All right.
High five.
It just swelled. Well, thank you again for being
thank
on our show. It was a pleasure
me.
Having
thank
you.
Thank you.
Greg, we got the CFO of the Pittsburgh Force again. Greg, you're getting to be a regular. Little Z, he's trying to challenge your record. He got two.
Oh, man, okay.
He got a long way to go.
Hold it, wait a second. I got to tell you, the original Wally Chip is actually Chip, and I can't count the number of shows he's been on.
It's probably 80,
but you're getting close to them. Gaining on them.
Gaining on
yeah,
them.
All of them. All right, so.
Once you invited me, you couldn't get rid of me.
No. I won't say he's like bad breath, but I just can't get rid of him. All right, Craig, enough of that. Let's get down to business with the Force. Tell the people your name and what you do again.
Craig McFeeters. I'm the Chief Financial Officer for the Pittsburgh Force Women's Football Team. And the reason I'm here today is to promote our next scheduled tryout. It will be on July the 14th. That's a Sunday at 5 p.m. at Martin Luther King Field on Kirkpatrick Street.
And that's July 14th.
July 14th.
Martin Luther King Field.
Ladies,
what time again?
5 p.m.
5 p.m.
Ladies 18 and older.
Okay. And we're still trying to get sponsors for the team.
Still trying to get sponsors.
$500, you can sponsor somebody on the team so they get their equipment. They'll be able to travel.
Absolutely.
And travel, they can play equipment. For 2014 when the season starts in April, I heard.
Next April, we're members of the WFA, the Women's Football Alliance.
Okay.
And we are coming back next April, and we're going to have a nice roster of gals ready to hit.
Good. You gave us a good report last week.
Yes.
But there's a lot of hard hitting, and some of these girls are rookies, so it's all good stuff.
And in the weeks to come, we're going to bring them into.
We've seen a few of them. Yeah. Now we want to see after they played a couple scrimmages if they're still on the team.
Yes.
That's what I was waiting for. I thought you'd bring a couple, but I guess.
We're working on schedules here.
Okay.
Get a bear,
and I understand most of them work.
Work, school.
And that's the other thing.
They're. Mothers to their kids, you know, and all that. So they have full schedules. So
well, we respect that.
So that's just like practice, you know, keeping the kids in line at home. It's just like going through.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly. Why don't you tell them again how they get a hold of you at the Pittsburgh Force?
There are a couple different ways. One, we have a website. It's www.pittsburghforce.net. And the second way is our phone number, 412-583-5774. And actually, I'll give you our email address. It's pittsburghforce@gmail.com.
That helps out. And then I heard you help people out in some business that you do. So I'll give you a little shameless promotion before I get you off of here. I'm trying to drum up some business for you.
Thank you very much. Yeah, I wear a few hats.
Tell us a couple. A
couple of them. Auditor for the Pittsburgh Housing Authority.
I don't gamble!
Oh, you don't live in a city.
And I also do some income taxes, accounting and income taxes.
There you go. Anyway, you'll leave the number and stuff so they can get a hold of us and we'll put it online again.
I'm here for the girls to promote them. And,
well, Pittsburgh Force, go Pittsburgh Force.
Go Force.
Come out and play.
Come out and play, and we're coming back in 2014.
It's halftime at Sip Sports Bar, 3024 West Liberty Avenue. If you come late, you can see our halftime show. All right, guys, there was a lot of great sports this past week, and let's touch on a couple of them.
Okay, I'll just start off right off the bat right now. Puck's about to drop. The Blackhawks are getting ready to close out the Bruins and to take home the Stanley Cup. That's the first thing. And the second thing I'd like to bring up real quickly, Pirates are on everybody's mind. They're red hot right now. And a lot of talk on the airwaves about the Pirates trading for somebody. And if you want my advice.
What's your normal line? Go ahead. I've been listening to
it. Don't trade anybody.
All right.
This team is set to win now, and they're positioned to win in the future. And, you know, the best thing the Pirates could do is let this team play it out. They're going to be in the playoffs this year. And, oh, by the way, I will be at the first playoff game in 20 years.
Whoa.
In Pittsburgh.
Stephanie, did you hear that?
I'm going to be there, too.
Okay.
Mark my words.
Just check it. Smoke and Jim, what's going on with you here, buddy?
Well, I tell you what, beautiful women make me nervous, so Alicia Sparks still got me shook up right now. But
boy, that table's moving around pretty good. There's a whole lot of shaking going on.
I'm happy to see her. But, hey, listen. Hey, listen. I always say a baby is born with just three fears. A fear of loud noises, a fear of heights, and a fear of Gateway. Hey, listen, Gateway's football team is ranked number one in the WPIL preseason, number one in the state, and number 10 right now in the nation, according to USA Today. They got three All-American defensive backs, maybe the best football team I ever seen in my life. Everybody get out this fall and join me at Anna Marino Stadium in the fall, babies.
Jim, you know, I hate to bust on your chops, but
go ahead.
They haven't played a game yet.
And that ends our halftime.
We illegally practice all summer long at Gateway.
Now that ends our halftime show. All right, that's it. Halftime's over. Hey, I'm glad you knew Karen Hall.
Oh, yeah.
Of fame that Smoke and Jim brought last week. It was a great show with her, great insights. And
I coached her at Mount Alvernia.
See that?
Oh, yeah.
And now he lives about 10 minutes away.
10?
5 minutes.
How about a drive and a wedge?
Wow, there's a golfer for you. I don't golf, so I don't understand that. It's maybe a sand trap you dug out of. All right, explain what this synthetic ice. If you need any props, you can show some. They'll try to catch something on the camera, but I don't know what we can do. Aaron might be able to pick something out.
Well, you go.
Or do you want your shirt there?
Well, you go to our website.
Just focus there.
Go to our website, www.futureskate.net. And it's actually a new product in Pennsylvania, in the Eastern Coast. It is a synthetic surface that you can train hockey players and kids can skate on.
So they can wear their skates?
Same hockey skates. The only thing you cannot put on are figure skates because it would dig into the ice and create a hole. It's a polyurethane product that is infused with oil. Okay?
Ah, there's a carbon footprint.
There
you know, geez.
There's another one, okay?
All right, well, we want to do this. What's it going to cost us? Can you tell us?
Well, it's a high-base product, okay? It's a high-cost product. People have to put it in their budget. We got a couple things going on right now with Scott Township. We got one going on with Bergenstown. We got one going on with a borough down in Florida.
So local townships, school districts, and everything else should look into this.
Everything.
Have you looked into approaching the NHL on this?
We have. And actually, if you go to our website, there's two hockey players that are on it, and they're pretty amazed by it, and they go wow on the video.
The reason I ask is they're planning on playing hockey games in warm
in the summer,
warm time of the year. They're playing games in like March or April, outdoor games, and how are they going to forget a frozen ice surface when it's 60 degrees outside? They're gonna be skating in slush.
Well, the one thing about the surface is it, because it's an oil-based product. Okay, the more you skate on it, the faster it is. Plus it is a UV protected product. So it's good inside, outside, 24/7, 365.
I don't know if Aaron can get this, but it was here at the Wing and Ribs.
Oh, yeah, it was.
South Park Labor Day. Look at that.
It looks like ice on Labor Day.
It was 92 degrees.
I think I got a job.
92 degrees. We had 190 kids.
Thanks,
on the
Eric.
first 5 hours we had it on. And then Saturday we had over 400 kids, and then Sunday it rained a little bit, but we still had 700 kids on the ice, on the surface.
It's a How product. Do I do with that?
Well,
that?
You did pretty good, Al.
Thanks.
Pretty good. Okay, I'm gonna send you a contract, yeah, but you did pretty good.
Hey, it's a no-cut deal. I got the pen. I got it already drawn up.
Got the contract
for you.
There.
Yeah, it's no-cut 5 years.
I mean, it's a high-cost product, but over time, if you think about building a traditional ice rink, it's $1.8 million with the ongoing cost of refrigeration, electricity.
Okay.
This would cost you about $330,000 and no ongoing cost. And plus, mine has a 10-year warranty, where most products on the market have a 3 to 5 year warranty. Mine is an oil-infused product that you don't have to lubricate. So it never wears out from the wind and the sun, all the evaporation. It doesn't.
Nice. So it can be outside?
Inside, outside, 24/7, 365, rain, snow, or shine.
Well, Marty, I appreciate you being here. That was a heck of a promo.
Thanks, man.
Anything else you want to promote before you go?
Well, we're pretty good. We're going to be at Burgerstein this weekend. They got the community.
What day is
Friday and Saturday this week down there. Then we're going to the Pittsburgh Wild Wing, or the Washington Wild Things.
Right.
Isn't
that their console energy out
yes.
there?
We're going there in August, and we're going to be down there 2 weekends in a row. And we're going to probably end up doing Scott Township within the next 4, 5, 6 months.
We got to get some BMX guys up here. I know we're on BPTV. They're in South Park. But you know what? I remember taking my son and his friends to the BMX track. And no, I'm not going on the BMX track. Matt already tried to get me on there. Matt, he's the announcer. Come on up. He friended me, so he's doing all the right things. He also likes Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. Welcome to the show.
Hello, man. Thanks for having me.
Hey, Matt. Tell everybody your name and what you do there.
My name is Matt Sedlak. I am the voice of South Park BMX. Those of you drive by every Wednesday and you hear a voice screaming from the track on Broughton Avenue.
I thought the police were chasing you that day.
Yeah, and not only that, but I also am an active racer out there as well. I race for Green Factor Racing, sponsored by Stats BMX, Profiled, Michael Cycles, Natrona Heights.
And I'm glad you talked fast, because our time's limited.
Brunner Contracting, you've seen the rest, call the best, Brunner Contracting. My good friend Zach Brunner.
What are you doing with these promotions here? I have a problem with that Brunner Contracting.
Yeah, Brunner Contracting.
I got to wash my towel again.
I got one of those too, man. He's a pro.
He told me I was special.
Yeah. He told me the same thing as well. Because I only give these out to certain people. Yeah. But yeah, gotta give it up for Zach for helping me get on here.
Zach,
to
thanks for bringing yes, Matt here.
Definitely,
appreciate it.
You know, a lot of people don't know about the BMX scene
Tell
in the area.
Tell us a little bit about.
And BMX in this area is growing. I mean, it's growing by the week. We see more and more riders out getting kids on bikes. We have kids from 2 years old doing striders all the way up to their 60s racing cruiser class.
There's a chance for me.
There's a chance for everyone. We get the big dude on a bike, man. We get you out there, man, owning that track. No doubt. Also, coming up on July 5th through the 7th, we have one of the biggest nationals in the country comes through South Park BMX. The UCI Olympic riders will be here at South Park BMX.
No!
You're going to
oh,
see...
explain what that means.
Those of you who saw the Olympics this year saw BMX racing.
I did.
We're going to have those riders here in South Park BMX doing their thing on our BMX track.
Is anybody taking a picture of you and me while you're telling us that? We'll post it up on Facebook. What's going on? You got your camera crew here.
My camera crew.
She's not taking any pictures. Get us all in here.
Camera crew here.
What is going
but
on?
But also, like I said, you're going to see. It's just.
You know what?
It's going to be madness.
Not only can I not hear my left ear, I can't see out of my left eye now.
And maybe not wear contacts.
Thank you.
But yeah, it's gonna be.
Tell us who your photographer is, she gets a shout out.
Ashley Georges does her own thing. Ashley Georges Photography. Max comes out, does handles of BMX track photography. Those action photos you see on my Facebook page.
Gotta
give it up, man. That's all her. And
we also can click off a few more pictures. with Pittsburgh Sportsline.
We also have a good friend George Frick that comes out every so often. He's a long time. You know, he takes pictures. He owned Team DVE back in the 90s. BMX at South Park goes all the way back to the late 70s. So
we gotta go.
Yeah.
Definitely guys gotta come out. We race. Our local races are every Wednesday. Registration's from 6 to 7, and our first gate drops at 7:30.
You know what? Maybe we can get a camera there. I won't volunteer anybody.
Yeah, come on out. Anybody wants to come on out, check it out.
I know a guy that lives real close to the studio.
Come find.
It's not me, because I can't handle the camera.
I tell you what, you come find me. You can hang out in the announce tower while I'm screaming the motos. You know, I even brought someone out with me. I say, if you're going to bring out to promote BMX, you want to bring out one of the best riders from the track. I brought with me a local pro rider.
We'll introduce him, and then we're going to get you out of here because we're trying to roll with all the guests. Thank you for being on our show. We're going to have you back again.
Oh, definitely. It's glad to be here. Thank you very much. But let me bring on to you single A pro Kyle McCrory, everyone.
My name's Kyle McCrory. I'm a pro BMX racer.
How long have you been doing this?
Since I was 8 years old.
As a pro?
Yeah. Well, no, not since as a pro, but I've been racing since I was 8.
I'm sarcastic, so I throw that out once in a while, and I get a lot of people.
You catch me off guard.
And you did well, because a lot of people get nervous, because this is being seen in the Pittsburgh area.
Yeah.
And then on Pittsburgh Sportsline Facebook, it's international.
Yeah.
Okay, and YouTube's all over the world.
Yep.
And you've been doing it as a pro how long?
I turned pro whenever I was 19.
19?
Yes.
That's great.
Yeah.
How many pro races do you have so far? Do you know?
Total? Since then? I don't know. I don't keep track over the years. This year I have
wins?
Six of them, though.
Do you count the wins that you have?
You count main event wins, not necessarily moto wins.
Okay.
So
maybe
kinda,
you want to explain how some of that
It's kind
of
like, basically, one BMX race is a lot like a season of football, where you have your motos, which is kind of like the regular season.
Okay.
So you can win or lose, but you still have another one to go. And then you have your quarters and your semis, which are basically like the playoffs. So once
you
lose, you're
out.
And if you win, you keep going forward. And then you have your main event, which is basically the Super Bowl. So you're judged, just like in football, you're judged by the Super Bowl. And in BMX, you're judged by your main events.
How many Super Bowls did you win then?
Whenever I was an amateur, I won a lot. But as a pro,
congratulations.
I haven't won yet. Yeah.
That's all right.
But I've gotten a couple top threes in the main. And
that's great.
Hopefully getting my first win this weekend at South Park, or next weekend at South Park.
And now the race for certain purses?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what do the purses go? I'm used to horse racing, where a horse will get 50%, 25%, 12, 8, and 5. They pay the top 5. What do they pay in
sport? It all depends on rider count. So if you get a lot of people that show up to the race, everybody's money goes into a purse, and
what's
it grows bigger.
What's your entrance fee then? What do you pay them?
$55 to enter per day. And that's as a single A pro, which is what I am, which is kind of like the minor leagues of baseball.
Okay.
But then you have your double A pros, which is kind of like the major leagues, and their purses are much larger. You're talking tens of thousands of dollars for like a day of racing.
All right, the single A, what's the purse that you would race for? If there's 100 guys, then what would you race
for? If there's 100 guys, you'd be racing for a couple grand.
Okay.
Which is not a bad payday for a day. But, I mean, the real money is whenever you get to the big leagues, double A's.
Sure.
And that's where you start making enough money to basically support yourself racing bicycles.
No, that's great.
So.
And then when do you plan on moving up? Do they move you up at a certain time, or you make a choice you want to spend more money to go there, or
you win enough single A pro mains in 1 year, you get moved up to the double A.
Okay.
So,
is there any other way to go? You just have to win the.
You have to win.
Up.
Okay. Yeah, you can't turn yourself up. You turn yourself from amateur to pro,
right.
But you can't turn yourself from single A pro to double A.
That's
pro.
That's what I was adding up there when you said you went from amateur to the $55 single A.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what made you decide? Do you have a full time job too?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I flip houses as well, and.
Well, if you want to promote that for 1 second, go ahead.
There's not much to promote. I look on the internet for foreclosed homes, and that's about it.
Well, we get a lot of people watching in the Pittsburgh area. Maybe they want to you could write it down on there.
Yeah, we can do something like that.
Else.
Yeah.
They can contact you. You seem like a nice stand-up guy.
I try.
And we're glad to have you on the show. We'd like to have you back.
All right. Thank
you. And good luck to you in July 5th to the 7th?
July 6th and 7th, yeah.
Bring home a winner. We'll bring you up. Do you get trophies or anything? If you win?
Money, not trophies.
Well, you're welcome to bring the money here anytime you want.
I will.
We go for the green.
All right.
All right. Hey, Kyle, you take care.
Thanks. Hey, can I say one thing? I got to say one thing. I met a lot of people in my lifetime. Never in my life have I met anybody as nice as Michael, a real gentleman, and we're going to do everything we can to help him out, man.
Thanks, Chip. Appreciate it.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks for being on the show. I appreciate it.
Thanks for having me. Thanks for all you guys are doing for boxing.
Since this is going out and there's a resurgence in boxing, we want you on board with this. Tell the people your name and where your gym's at in Oakland.
So. Okay.
Hey, take your hand off my T-shirt, brother.
My name is...
It's going to end up in his folder.
Yeah, it's Mike McSorley with the Colin Greb Boxing Club. Thanks, it's in North Oakland. We founded it last fall, and it's been going really well. We've been keeping busy.
How many rings do you have there? Do you have a couple?
It's a small kind of an old school gym. We got one ring, and just basically pretty raw, just everything you kind of need. And I found it with a couple guys from I went to Central Catholic with a couple attorneys who used to box, and we'll be seeing Central or Gateway in a couple months here.
Nice.
Sure. Nice. So yeah, I'm gonna be with you at the game, Jim. So okay, I take a little side wager here.
Well, he's known to wager, and I don't want to bring up about a couple of the bets he just made recently. Another house is lost, so we need football to come back so we can get the house back.
Absolutely.
So, Mike, you're invited to bet him anytime.
All right, sounds good.
And
sounds good.
How many boxers do you have in your gym since you just started up?
We just started right now. Really, we only have we have about three or four. A couple pros, a couple amateurs coming down, and we have a lot of good pro sparring there. We're actually having a couple guys come down tomorrow night. And a few of us were down with our good friend Jimmy Savedic's gym, Third Avenue.
We just saw Jimmy Savedic this weekend. What a legend.
He is. He's a classic guy and a very close friend. And I had the space in Oakland, and timing was right. And it's all kind of coming together really well.
No, that sounds great. Yeah. We're all about promoting this stuff. You're welcome back on our show. And we'll do whatever we can to promote. Do you have anything else that you want to promote special here?
Absolutely. Yeah, there's going to be a nice card Rod Salk is doing August 3rd. It's going to be in the Strip. It's great lineup. We have a fighter from our gym who I think you guys are going to be bringing up, Kian Dalton.
What's his name again?
Irish Kian Dalton from Ireland. He's 2-0 in the pro ranks. And
what weight class is he?
He's fighting this one at light heavyweight. The last fight was at 168.
Okay.
And so he can fight between 168 and 175. But he's been getting a lot of really good sparring around town. We have a lot of guys, gyms from Youngstown come down to our place as far as well. We go up there frequently too and stuff. So we make the rounds, and we're going up to New York to get some good sparring in before this fight as well. So
it sounds great. We're big fans of Rod Salk. He brought his belt here, the NABA belt, when he won. He's been on the show a couple times.
He's fighting a really tough guy from Colombia, Ivan Hernandez.
Ooh, he's fighting Ivan.
Yeah, he's 29-3. Ooh. And Paul Spadafora is also fighting on the show.
Right.
And he's fighting Walter Castillo from Nicaragua.
And don't forget Justin Bergman.
Yes. Yep.
Right?
Bergman.
See,
and
we talk a little. Little Z's all over this stuff.
Yeah.
I don't know if you know Little Z.
We just met.
Zach Brenner.
Yes. Right before the show here. But the Bergman fight's going to be a good one. He's fighting Nikolai Firtha. And those guys are
both. You got all the right information.
I got a little cheat sheet.
This is TV. Talk about a cheat sheet. Wait, here's a T-shirt for Smoking Jim.
Absolutely.
Don't talk about that, because that fight, we're running out of a little bit of time. We got to get this
good
in here.
So here's a shirt for the gym.
Hold it up so Aaron can get that.
There you go.
There's some great boxers on there. You want to say who's on there?
This is Billy Kahn and Harry Greb, and Billy Kahn's son Tim is a member of our gym. He's donated a lot of great memorabilia and works out there, and many people
give it to him because
he's going to be lost on the way over there. But the other fighter is Harry Greb, and Harry Greb's from Garfield. Many boxing historians consider him to be the greatest of all time, without question, top three fighter of all time. But
great history.
And Kahn and Greb are both from the east end of Pittsburgh, where our gym is from.
And there's now a Billy Kahn Street, I think.
There is, yes, right down in Oakland. So
definitely.
Where's Harry Greb from?
He's from Garfield. Pride of Garfield.
No, he didn't say Gateway.
Garfield. No, I appreciate your time.
No, thank you for having us. And if anybody needs tickets, you can contact us at 412-728-3409. It's going to be a great fight.
You've got to repeat it again, because if you don't repeat it, we don't pay attention.
Okay.
So.
It's 412-728-3409.
And we're also going to promote this on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. So you'll see that. We'll promote and help you whatever we can.
I appreciate
all you guys doing. It's going to be a great day in Pittsburgh in the Strip District.
Absolutely.
So it'll be fantastic.
Fun night. Great fights. Mike, thanks for having us.
Thank you for being on.
Thanks for all you do, guys. I really appreciate it.
Look at the shape this guy's in here. You look like you're ready to fight tonight.
I'm ready.
That's good.
Bring it on.
Got a punching bag for you, right?
Hey, wait a second. Smoking Jim told me to be in the rope with this. All right? Yeah. Hey, hey, don't hit me.
Your body there.
I don't care. It's all muscle. Why don't you tell the people your name and how you got here and how you ended up in the gym here in Oakland?
My name is Kian Dalton. From Ireland, been in Pittsburgh about two, three years. I actually came here for a job in wind power.
Really? Do you work in the wind power industry?
I do.
You can mention who you work for. We don't mind promoting a little bit.
I work for a company called EverPower.
And it's all green energy.
It's all green energy.
Because you know what we do? We go for the green with the main here. All right? I sort of had a feeling. This is for a little bit of fun, too. I knew you had to have a full-time job here, too.
Unfortunately.
I know. Yeah. Well, maybe after the August 3rd.
Maybe.
You won't need that wind power job. You'll have some green in hand.
Just don't tell them you said that.
This isn't going out anywhere on Verizon 32, Comcast 7 in Bethel Park, YouTube, and Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. This video will be up as soon as tomorrow. And they don't watch it, so don't tell them. So how's your training coming along?
Training's coming well. I'm moving up a weight division, up to light heavyweight. I was at super middle at 168. So
you look so thin.
Yeah.
Are you going to have to gain some weight?
No, I can move between the two pretty easily. I've always been...
Do you knock people out then?
Yeah.
Okay.
I won first fight by knockout.
Okay, because I like people that are honest, and you were starting to make a fist there, so I figured you could knock somebody out.
Yeah, I can.
That's good. So you've had two pro fights. And this will be your third coming up on August 3rd. I think all the stars are lining up. The third fight on the 3rd. Sounds great.
Yeah.
Now, I wish you the best of luck on that. You got to come back after the fight. When you have a win, you can come back, and you're welcome anytime. Whether you're working at Wind Power or boxing, you're welcome.
Gentlemen.
Well, here, I'll wait.
Okay.
Representing. All right,
we ready for...
The foundation of the steel curtain.
Yes.
Steel Nation, the building block right there.
All right, well, we got little Z here, and normally we kid around and we have a lot of good things and fun things, but little Z suffered a loss. It just happened. He lost his aunt in an accident, a terrible, horrific accident. She was riding her bicycle, got hit, so he is pretty sad. He's usually a very upbeat guy. He worked all day, was stuck on a roof, so he's baked up, and... I just wanted to take a few seconds here in honor of her and Chip's mother who passed away. My dad had passed away 2 years ago on Father's Day. I'd like to honor anybody that suffered any losses. The owner of the place here that I can't mention his name, he went to 4 funerals last week. So any of these people and any loved ones that you've lost, I'd like to at least take 30 seconds, to just pause here out of respect to the families and their loss. Stephanie lost a grandmother, so I'd like to at least, have a moment of silence here. Thank you. And I count every second, little Z.
I know.
All right, because they're all good people. You're a good man. And our time's limited again, buddy. Man. You brought so many guests on that.
Hey, that's my aunt would want Smoking Jim to have a Clayton Bears towel.
I'll take it instead. I need another towel.
In honor of my aunt.
Clean. This is clean for Levine. Okay.
And
smoking, you can have that.
While we're in the memory of my aunt, we communed via email a lot because she worked for the State Department, so she spent time in Barbados, London, all over many U.S. embassies. So the way I got to communicate with my aunt was always through letters and through the post office, through the mail. So the last letter I got from my aunt, she was able to catch one of the April shows that we taped right here at Sip Sports Bar, and I just wrote down three or four of the comments that she said to me. The first one was, she said, "Is Smoking Jim always that loud?"
Yes.
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 The second thing she said to me, and I'm sorry, Steph, she said, "Chip's cute." So, you know, God rest her soul. At least she had good taste in men. You know, you can agree with that, you know.
You can't argue with that.
And lastly, and one of the last things she said to me, aside from myself, she said, "Al Levine has great hair." So she made...
Hold it. Oh, I need a haircut.
Throw back to the 80s.
I didn't get to get my hair cut. My girl wasn't in. And as Azu, Marianne wasn't there, little Z. I don't know when you did work. She hasn't been back since. So I'm going to try to go in Wednesday.
So,
but what a great aunt you had.
She was a great woman, and I wore this jersey because one of her favorite Steelers of the 70s was Joe Green.
That was her favorite player.
And underneath for Smoking Jim, I got my Clayton Bears championship back-to-back-to-back. You know, we got the hat, man. Like, we're just repping Clayton tonight, man.
You want to tuck that in honor, here. Tuck that under the beer.
Yes, in honor of my aunt, we're representing Clayton tonight. You know, Smoking Jim, too, for one day. He's a bear.
He's just taking free stuff because I can't get it. This is, give me that. Come on back.
Hey, that's two what good else, things little to have. That's two good things
to have. You're out of being the machine.
Well, you just met one of the gentlemen that's going to be fighting August 3rd.
Yeah,
so obviously you two guys will be there. So I'll be there in charge of the security. So it's going to be a great night down there at the 31st Street Studios in the Strip District. So I'm looking forward to it very much so. It's a Saturday night. And hopefully we can get Chip, Stephanie, we can get everybody
all day, then to the evening there, 31st Street Studio.
And then maybe late into the evening, Smoking Jim. We're going to go way late into the evening on Saturday night. Hopefully we got some celebrations to do with some champions on Saturday night, you know.
Batman will be there.
Batman has an early exit a lot of times. You might have to put the security grab on him, okay?
That's fine. We're going to put an ankle brace on
him. I saw him leave the other night. I was talking to Jimmy Savetic, and all of a sudden, Batman was gone. So I don't know what happened there. He was talking to me, and I looked around. Well, so, hey, what else do you want to talk about? We got to wind this down. We're getting close here now.
Yeah, I just want to thank everybody at home for the thoughts and the prayers that they've gave to my family in this time. And thank you to Bethel Park TV, Aaron, Devin, you guys, everybody up here, Al, Jim, Chip, everybody that came out tonight. I see we got some guys from 51 Boxing that came out too, even though they were a little late, as always. Hey, better late
than
never.
Is that little Teddy's son?
It is little Teddy.
Oh, that's JB. Teddy! Where's the new little Teddy?
I got real quiet in here. Sorry, folks.
You guys come too late. There's Justin there. There's a guy that stole my seat.
JT the Brick!
Is that the Brick? The Brick's here. Justin's here.
Hey,
next week, we're going to have Pittsburgh Boxing at 51. Who's hiding in the back? Steve. Steve's there. He gave me some expert tips I'm not allowed to talk about on air. Hey, I want to thank everybody for watching the show. Tina, she's not an aunt anymore. I don't care what the kamikaze kid says. It's a great place to come. 3024 West Liberty Avenue, Sip Sports Bar. Thanks for watching us on Verizon 32. Thanks to BBTV, Dave Cable, Aaron Ward, Devin Shay.
The intern.
Don't shoot me. He's still in military chemo.
Alan, let's not forget. Let's go Bucks.
Hey, let's go Bucks.
is Alex Barker, the Amazing.
I'm Jacob Wagner.
Hi, I'm Austin.
This is Scout 350, and you're watching BPTV. Isn't that awesome?